When working with databases such as MariaDB, early on in your career, you're going to find out that there are two things that many will make assumptions on or completely forget about. This will be a mistake, and those people are going to end up with massive headache. These are the less logical aspects of human data, such as time and character sets. Today, I'm going to focus on working with time and date. It can be really difficult, and I'll talk about why and the ways you can simplify it. I'm going to start with a simple example. Say I gave you the date 1/2/20. I'm pretty certain those of you viewing in the US would say I'm talking about the 2nd of Jan 2020, whereas most of the rest of you would think I'm talking about the 1st of February 2020. Although I could have also been referring to 1920, depending on when I actually wrote the date. There is ambiguity in how we communicate dates to each other, especially when that communication crosses international boundaries. The same is often true with time. In many countries, there are people that are used to having a 12-hour clock. So when I say, I need to do this by 8 o'clock, am I talking about morning or evening? Even worse, someone in the US could say, let's have a conference call at 1 p.m. Well, is that my time zone or is that your time zone? And which of these six US time zones are you even in? There's an industry standard to remove the ambiguity in time and date representations called ISO 8601. Date format for this is a 4-digit year, a dash, a 2-digit month, a dash, and a 2-digit day. This is a big endian way of representing the date, which means the most significant digits first. Even if you've never seen it this way before today, it's a relatively simple way to figure out no matter where in the world you're from. The standard also includes representation of time in a 24-hour format. It even has representation of time zones. If you've done any work using date time, or timestamp data types in MariaDB, you'll be used to this format. The time and date itself is a difficult thing to work with for three reasons that I'll cover here. The first is time zones, the second is daylight savings, and the third is leap seconds. I'm going to briefly talk about these and how you should handle them in your application. So first, let's talk about time zones. As most of you are aware, there are many time zones around the world. I live in the UK, so we have GMT, which stands for Greenwich Mean Time, named after the Royal Observatory in Greenwich, London. Some countries have many, and some switched time zones. For example, in 2011, Samoa switched which side of the international dateline it was on and lost an entire day. They went from a Thursday to a Saturday, completely skipping Friday. Not all time zones are one hour offsets either. There are some that are half hour and some that are 15 minute offsets. There have even been times where the time zone is different depending on your religion. All this makes for keeping track of time zones really hard, especially when dealing with historical dates and times. Now on to daylight savings time. Many viewers here will live in countries that have daylight savings time. I'm not going to get into the historical political reasons why they exist, but they do exist to make a programmer's life a nightmare. There are countries that will decide with only a few days' notice that they will or won't observe daylight savings, and others that will arbitrarily change the dates they start and end daylight savings on. About 12 years ago, I was working on some software that was working with various time zones. One of the tests someone wrote for the test suite was constantly failing. It was using Unix time, which is a representation of the number of seconds since midnight, 1st of Jan 1970. And it was checking that the date and time code was returning 1970:01:01:00:00 for Unix time 0. But it said it was returning 1 a.m. The conversion was set to London time, and I thought, well, that should be winter GMT time. Why is that failing? After some historic investigation, it turns out that UK was doing a permanent daylight savings trial from 1969 to 1971. So we were 1 hour offset from GMT, despite, Greenwich literally being in the UK. Many countries have different start and end dates for daylight savings. Also, countries in the southern hemisphere can have their start and end dates the opposite way around to the northern hemisphere due to the axis the Earth is on. Oh, and did I forget about the time in the 1940s where the UK had double daylight savings? Yep, there was really a period where we shifted by 2 hours. So again, you not only need to consider the time zone now, but if you're dealing with even slight historic dates and times, the time zone back then too. So how do we resolve these two problems? First of all, never try and code this stuff yourself. Every operating system has fantastic libraries that keep track of all this for you. Use them, it'll save you so much pain. MariaDB itself has a tool called MariaDB TZ Info to SQL. It will take the time zone information from the operating system and put it into a table. For simple applications where you're dealing with one time zone, this is completely fine, completely usable. But for anything where you may need more than one time zone, I wouldn't recommend having the database handle this. This is because that time zone information can change on an almost daily basis and doesn't deal really well with historical data. Instead, my recommendation is storing time and date within MariaDB using the UTC standard. Now, UTC stands for Coordinated Universal Time. Yes, the acronym is in the wrong order. This was due to a linguistic compromise to avoid favoring the order of letters in any given language. It's not technically a time zone, since there's no country that officially observes it, but it's pretty much the same as GMT. But there are some notable differences, which we'll get to in a minute. The beauty of using UTC is that your application can take the date and time from the MariaDB database and use the operating system's based time zone information to work out the time and date in any country at any point in time. The data is also pretty much portable to other systems in other countries. MariaDB's timestamp data type uses UTC internally and can convert between the server's time zone and UTC if they're different. It's worth checking out the time zone knowledge base page for more information on this, so you can understand the various behaviours. A link to this is in the description below. Finally, onto leap seconds. Everyone knows there are 60 seconds in a minute. What if I told you that it's possible to have 61 seconds in a minute? GMT and a few other time zones are legally based on an observation of solar time, whereas UTC is based on atomic clocks. The problem here is atomic clocks are way too accurate, and the world is a bit more like a big ball of wibbly wobbly timey wimey stuff. There are irregularities that can happen with the observed solar time because the Earth speeds up and slows down slightly all the time, in addition to a slight constant slowdown of the Earth's rotation. Since GMT is based on solar time, it can be up to 0.9 seconds different in either direction from UTC. Despite this, most modern clocks are based on atomic time and sync to UTC rather than using solar time, because it makes things a lot easier. For very time-sensitive operations where you're using MariaDB, having a clock drift daily slightly could be seen as a bad thing, but occasionally that drift is too much, and if we do not correct for this over long periods of time, the clock would not match the time of day observed by GMT. Leap seconds were implemented to solve this drift, and are in the UTC standard as well as many time zones that are not based on solar observation. They're typically announced around 6 months in advance and normally mean that exactly 59 or 61 seconds are in a certain predefined minute. At the time of recording, the last leap second was December 31st, 2016. That means many of you celebrating New Year's 2017 celebrated it a second early. When this happens, the clock could go from 23:59:58, 23:59:59, 23:59:60, and then 00:00:00. It could also go to 23:59:58 and then go straight to 00:00:00. How you handle this depends on how seconds really matter to you. The Unix time standard used in MariaDB's timestamp data type will account for this by repeating the leap second. So you may have an extra data for that 1 second if you have many inputs per second. You could also look at using International Atomic Time, or TAI. Yes, another acronym completely in the wrong order in English. TAI basically uses the atomic clock, but completely ignores the concepts of leap seconds, slowly drifting further and further away from time as we know it. It's more commonly used in astronomical and navigational applications. At the time I'm recording this, TII is 37 seconds ahead of UTC, so there'll be some complicated conversions going on, but it is monotonic, which means it's always going forward and it will not add leap seconds. After a leap second caused big problems for Google, they implemented something called a leap smear into their time servers. So on the day of the leap second, they deliberately spread the extra second out over the length of the entire day. Google has an entire reference page dedicated on how this works, and I fully recommend you check it out. There's a link to this also in the description below. UTC, whilst having quirks, is very well understood by the standard libraries in pretty much every programming language. They all have conversion functions to any time zone based on the open source time zone information the operating system manages and keeps up to date. As a side note, I highly recommend enabling MariaDB's SQL modes, no zero date and no zero in date, along with strict all tables. In the Gregorian calendar, which is the calendar most of us and MariaDB data types use, there is no year zero. It goes from 1 BC to 1 AD. Null is likely a better option for most of the cases where you'd want to use a zero date. So a zero date is likely bad data, and in many cases it's better to error on bad data than allow it. In summary, time and date can be really hard. I haven't even touched on subjects such as countries switching calendars at different points in history yet, which is why I always recommend storing time and date in the simplest form possible and letting experts who dedicate their lives to getting this right handle the conversions for you. If you ever come across them, they definitely deserve a drink on you. Thank you. Thank you.